Hi, I'm Mike Ramirez with Kantar Health. Today I'm briefly going to go over the ESMO 2020 abstract detailing the results from the CheckMate 9ER trial in renal cell carcinoma, or RCC. So this is a pivotal trial. It's evaluating the combination of Opdivo and Cabometyx in first-line metastatic RCC. Now, among the clear cell carcinoma patients, which this trial was focused on, approved regimens include Keytruda and Lida, Bavencio and Lida, Opdivo, Yervoy, Sutent monotherapy, and Cabometyx monotherapy. So usage of these different regimens varies by risk stratification. Before ESMO, it was announced that the CheckMate 9ER trial had met its primary PFS endpoint, as well as some secondary OS and ORR endpoints. At this year's ESMO, we got a first look at the numerical data, and it's quite positive, as we might expect. In terms of PFS, the combo showed a median PFS of 16.6 months, compared to 8.3 months in the Sutent comparator arm, which, as I mentioned before, is also approved and is mainly used in patients with favorable risk. In terms of population demographics, favorable risk patients comprised 23% of the evaluated population, while the rest were intermediate or poor risk. So bear that in mind that in the real world, other regimens such as in Keytruda and Lida would also be available. However, this trial initiated before these newer combinations were approved, hence the Sutent comparator, which has now been displaced as the standard of care. The ORR for the combination was 56%, 27% for Sutent, so a substantial boost there. Hazard ratio for overall survival was 0.6 in favor of the combination, amounting to a 40% reduction in the risk of death compared to Sutent. In terms of safety, there were no notable concerns. Opdivo Cabometyx had a slightly higher rate of treatment-related adverse events, but there was not an overall increase in trial discontinuations in that arm. So clearly, in the favorable risk patients, the data strongly suggests that this combination should be considered in addition to Keytruda and Lida, as well as in poor and intermediate risk patients as well, in addition to Opdivo Yervoy. So it's unlikely that we'll ever see a head-to-head comparison of these regimens, but looking across trials, it appears that this combination compares well to both Keytruda and Lida and Opdivo Yervoy, which were compared to Sutent comparator arms as well. So we feel that there is a high likelihood of approval and uptake, and certainly one to watch for years to come in this indication.